Hi, I'm Claire Pires, and I'm the host of GLAAD All Access, GLAAD's video series that features interviews with newsmakers, hitmakers, and people accelerating acceptance. Today, I'm interviewing Maria Bello about her new book, Whatever Love is Love. Take a look.
When I wrote my New York Times article, Whatever Love is Love, I talked about family and partnership and the labels that we give ourselves and each other and how those labels seem to be outdated. When I look at the new gender options, for instance, from Facebook, there's 51 new ones, I go, I'm at least 15. So I'm like a proud part of the LGBT community. This is the community who has been one of the leaders in human rights.
One of your chapters is called Am I a Catholic? And I'm wondering if you're still a Catholic and if you have any advice for someone who lives at this intersection of both being religious and also believing in the way that they identify.
I didn't think that I could reclaim the label of Catholic, even though I went to 16 years of Catholic school.
Right.
My dearest friend at university was a Catholic priest. He was my partner in so many ways. But then I remembered that it was really a faith based in love, really, at the end. And I have seen, not only through this Pope, but through so many other supporters, this more of an acceptance of every person and every orientation, whatever you do, whoever you are. And so I've reclaimed that.
And after studying at Villanova, you were really into women's issues and you call yourself a feminist in the book. So I'm wondering how you think the women's movement and the LGBT movement can work in tandem.
I think that GLAAD's mission, what you've done from the beginning, and what we're doing now, puts those two things together. It's about diverse voices, okay? So diverse in gender, diverse in sexual orientation, diverse in race, diverse in country, and in the media, GLAAD really working on portraying that and making sure that that happens, that those voices are heard. That's a mission that our production company, Ground 7, has as well.
How has this whole experience changed you personally?
I'm so proud of my family. There's so much love in our lives. Mm-hmm. And to be able to ask those questions, because my book is really about questions.
Mm-hmm.
And the question is, who are my partners? Who are these people that have been standing by my side for so long? And I am incredibly, incredibly proud of my family and excited to open up the larger conversation. I didn't know it would be so large. I thought it would be, okay, I wrote this article, but within an hour we had like 273,000 Facebook likes of people saying, I'm a whatever, and I didn't know what to call it. I have a whatever family. Traditional labels, a lot of them can be limiting and outdated.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I realized questioning all of these labels I had given myself and other people gave me, that the only labels that really matter are the ones I give myself. And to be a part of a community that you're proud of, to own that label. So to embrace the labels that empower you and to let go of the ones that disempower you. I'm Maria Bello and I got your back.